To the Honorable Chairperson of the Professional Regulation Commission, Ma'am Teresita Arbanzala, thank you for that very inspiring message. To the Honorable Members of the Board of Environmental Planning, being led by its Chairman, Honorable Josefina Ramos, together with Honorable Lirio Abuyuan and Honorable Dolores Enriga. To the officers, members, and staff of the Philippine Institute of Environmental Planners, headed by President ENP Maria Encarnacion Raralio. To the 2012 PRC Outstanding ENP of the Year awardee, and who is also our guest speaker this afternoon. You will get to know more about him later. Guests, fellow passers, good afternoon. Parang kailan lang tayo ay nagsusunod ng kilay para maghanda sa board exam. Ilang weekends, pelikula, telenovela ang ating pinalampas upang magbasa ng sandamakmak na batas, libro at planning manuals. Nagulat pa yung ating mga kaibigan dahil hindi na nila tayo masyado nakakasama sa mga gimmick o kaya naman ay hindi nila tayo nakikita man lang sa Facebook at sa Twitter. Naalala ko pa na sa tuwing matatapos ang bawat exam, tayo ay nagtatanungan kung ano ang tamang sagot sa mga tanong na nahirapan tayong sagutin. Nagtataka kung bakit sa dinami-dami ng ating mga binasa, may mga tanong pa rin na hindi natin inasahan na susulpot. Pakiramdam natin, tila imposible na tayong pumasa. Tama ba? Personally, para sa akin, nandoon ang kaba dahil nagkataon na sa susunod na araw ay aking kaarawan. Hindi ko alam kung magiging happy ang birthday ko kinabukasan. Mula Biyernes hanggang Lunes, hindi tayo makapag-concentrate sa trabaho at sa mga gawain kasi paulit-ulit nating nare-refresh ang PRC website. Baka may announcement na. At nung inilabas na ang resulta, para tayong nabunutan ng tinik sa dibdib. Napasigaw, o doon sa mga nahihiya, gustong sumigaw sa tuwa. And now, the moment that we all have been waiting for is finally here. We are fortunate indeed because among those who took the exam, kasama tayo sa mga nanumpa ngayon. Sorry. On the day the exam results were released, my Facebook wall, I'm sure inyo rin, was flooded with greetings from family members, friends, classmates, and office mates. The following day, a colleague in the provincial government asked, ENP ka ba? Thinking that this one of the boy pick-up lines, I answered, bakit? Then she answered, ano yun? Unsure that she will understand the gamut of functions of the profession, I simply answered, basically, we prepare land use and site development plans as well as prepare feasibility and feasibility studies. Then later that day, I asked myself again the same question. What is it really to become an environmental planner? In spite of its early existence, our profession as environmental planners is less popular or less known when compared to other professions like medicine, engineering, and architecture, perhaps maybe just in the Philippines. And as I continue to reflect on the question, what an ENP is, I came with a meaning for each, for the letters of the ENP, ENNP. I hope you will agree. EN, we are enablers. We become enablers when we serve as policy advisors to elected officials and political leaders, especially at the local levels, who usually who have the power. There are some local government units who are lucky to have visionary leaders who care about and set the direction of their towns. They enroll themselves to planning and public administration courses to equip themselves so they can govern better. However, Their number is relatively lower, or shall I say, their species is rare and endangered as compared to those who use the traditional style. They need planners to help them make sound decisions, as well as craft programs and projects that are development-oriented and responsive to the needs of the people. As planners, we also become enablers when we share our knowledge and expertise in the academe and resource persons to local communities. Teaching not only empowers the people through learning, but also creates a multiplier effect because we increase the number of our partners in development. P, protector and promoter of the general welfare. We become protectors of the general welfare when we act as regulators of development. More than preparing and designing towns, we protect the people when we protect the environment where they live and make a living. When we shield it from selfish interests of the few and the powerful. On the other hand, we promote the general welfare when we include the various sectors of society and consider their needs and interests in the planning and decision-making processes. Last week, the highest leader of our country reported to his bosses the accomplishments of his administration. Whatever our reactions to this more than 1 hour litany of achievements and promises, at the end of the day, there is a call to each and every one of us, a call to action, to promote the general welfare of the Filipino people. In his 1954 State of the Nation address, President Ramon Magsaysay emphasized on the need for a concerted action and national unity in the face of problems the country is facing. And I quote, "More than ever, we must think, plan, and work as one, with only one supreme goal in mind, the promotion of the welfare and happiness of the people. As planners, we are also called to be leaders, to be at the forefront, to help achieve this goal. Before I end, allow us to extend our warmest and sincerest thanks to all those who helped us. First of all, to God, our Father, who helped and guided us from the day we started preparing for and until we successfully passed the board exam. To Him be the highest glory. Of course, let's give a round of applause for our teachers, professors, and mentors who selflessly shared their time, knowledge, and experience. Kayo po ang isa sa mga dahilan kung bakit kami nandito ngayon. Again, our deepest thanks to all of you. At this point, may I request my fellow passers to please rise and face towards your family, friends, and special someone, para dun sa mga may kasama po who are with us today. And let us give them the loudest applause. Thank you for all the love and support that you have given us, especially when we were preparing for the board exam. Para po sa inyo ang araw na ito. Pwede na pumupo. At sa mga kapwa ko, bagong ENPs, sa araw na ito, kasabay ng pagbuhos ng ulan na dulot ni Bagyong Hiner, ay ang pagbuhos ng biyaya sa ating lahat. Today, we receive a special gift. We were sworn as new environmental planners. Ika nga ng iba, lisensyado na tayo. We are now full-fledged planners. Atin po itong pagyamanin para sa ating mga sarili at sa bayan. Malay natin, sa batch na ito magmumula ang mga susunod na most outstanding environmental planners kagaya ni Sir Nathaniel. May we also use this responsibly and with accountability. Huwag po nating sayangin ang pagkakataong ito na pinagkakaloob sa atin. Milyong-milyong mga Pilipino at mga lokal na pamahalaan ang umaasa at nangangailangan ng ating tulong. And as we pursue and practice our profession in our own fields, as we face its challenges and trials, let us remember this very important day in our lives when we gave our solemn oath to become ENPs, enablers, and protectors and promoters of the general welfare. May we keep this pledge in our minds and hearts and be our guiding light. Again, thank you very much and may God bless us all.